I'd like to call to order the April 3rd, 2017 Old Bridge Town Council meeting. Please rise for a pledge of allegiance, followed by the prayer and a moment of silence.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Mr. Miles, the prayer, please.
Yes, sir. O Lord, bless thy servants in the ministry of public affairs who serve thee in this chamber. Give them quiet minds and hearts that they may hear thy voice. Help them to know when to speak, when to be silent. Give them strength to oppose the wrong and uphold the right, and grant that they have a good conscience and soul at peace with thee and with one another. Amen.
Amen. As is customary in this chamber, we always stand for a moment of silence to honor those men and women who are fighting both home and abroad to protect our freedoms, our first responders, and those that have given the ultimate sacrifice. Moment of silence, please. Thank you. Please be seated.
This meeting is being held in conformance with the Open Public Meetings Act. Notice of the meeting has been given to the newspaper, and notice of the meeting has been posted in public places. Next open public meeting of the council will be held on Monday, April 17, 2017, at 7:30 p.m. Mrs. Dungy.
Present.
Dr. Greenberg.
Here.
Mr. Miles.
Here.
Mr. Rosenkranz.
Here.
Mrs. Sohar.
Here.
Mrs. Walker.
Here.
President Cahill.
Here.
Seven present.
Seven present. We have a quorum. We'll go right to the proclamations and certificates. Proclamation recognized the month of April as Sexual Assault Awareness Month and the observing of Denim Day on Wednesday, April 26, 2017. Mr. Mayor.
Good evening, everyone. Sexual Assault Awareness Month and an observance of Denim Day are intended to draw attention to the fact that sexual violence is widespread and has public health implications for every community member of Middlesex County, including a lifelong mental health impact. Sexual assault, sexual abuse, and sexual harassment greatly impact our community. As statistics indicate, 1 in 4 girls and 1 in 6 boys are sexually abused before the age of 18, with many more experience other types of sexual violence in their adult life. Prevention is possible, so we must work together to educate our community about what can be done to stop sexual violence while supporting survivors. Staff and volunteers of anti-violence and prevention programs in Middlesex County, including the Middlesex County Center for Empowerment and Sexual Violence Prevention Coalition, encourage every person to speak out when witnessing acts of violence, however small, and to challenge the social norms that continue to perpetuate cultural of violence. The New Jersey Sex Crime Defenders Association and the Middlesex County Sex Crimes Liaison Officers, in connection with the Middlesex County Prosecutor's Office, are dedicated to ensuring the effective investigation and prosecution of sex crimes in our community to integrity, collaboration, and training. With the leadership, dedication, and encouragement, there are compelling evidence that we can be successful in reducing sexual violence here in Old Bridge Township through increased awareness, prevention, education, focus on increasing gender equality, healthy relationships, bystander intervention, and holding perpetrators who commit acts of violence responsible for their actions. Throughout the month of April 2007, Old Bridge Township strongly supports the efforts of national, state, and local partners and every citizen to actively engage in public and private efforts, including conversations about what sexual violence is, how to prevent it, how to help survivors connect with services, and how every segment of our society can work together to better address sexual violence. Now, therefore, I, Owen Henry, Mayor of Old Bridge Township, County of Middlesex, State of New Jersey, do hereby proclaim April 2017 as Sexual Assault Awareness Month and proclaim that we join anti-sexual violence advocates and support service programs in the belief that all community members must be part of the solution to end sexual violence and encourage the observation of Denim Day on Wednesday, April 26, 2017. Mayor Owen Henry. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Hey, Sue, you can pick that up now. We'll move on to the bill list. Mr. Rosenkranz.
Thank you, Council President. Bill list for April 3rd, 2017, accounts payable,
$8,465,571.44.
Have a motion, please.
I'll move it.
Moved by Mr. Rosenkranz. Can I have a second? Mr. Mahal, second. Any questions? Seeing and hearing none, roll call, please.
Mrs. Dungy?
Yes.
Dr. Greenberg?
Yes.
Mr. Mahalis?
Yes.
Mr. Rosenkranz?
Yes.
Mrs. Sohar?
Yes.
Mrs. Walker?
Yes.
President Cahill?
Yes.
Payroll, March 31st, 2017, $914,721.39.
Have a motion, please.
I'll move it.
Moved by Mr. Rosenkranz, second by Mr. Mahalis. Any questions? Mrs. Dungy? No? Okay. Roll call, please.
Mrs. Dungy?
Yes.
Dr. Greenberg?
Yes.
Mr. Mahalis?
Yes.
Mr. Rosenkranz?
Yes.
Mrs. Sohar?
Yes.
Mrs. Walker?
Yes.
President Cahill?
Yes.
7 yes.
Payroll overtime, March 31st, 2017, $56,094.07.
I get a motion, please.
I'll move it.
Moved by Mr. Rosenkranz. Can I have a second?
I'll second that.
A second by Mr. Mahalis. Mr. Manchu, Hashak, can you please break out the overtime, please?
Sure. Thank you, Mr. President. As Councilman Rosenkranz indicated, the total overtime was $56,094.07. Of that, we had a March snow overtime, snow-related overtime was $22,467.06. The total sworn officers overtime was $25,263.40 for this period, representing 392.75 men and women hours. There was no deduction for the grants. Deduction for ETO, the contractual payment was $4,686.96, making net overtime $20,576.44. Of that, $3,818.68 was for the snow coverage. There is one vacancy, two officers injured on duty, and one officer is on a military leave.
Okay, thank you. Any questions for Mr. Shaw on the overtime? Seeing and hearing none, roll call, please.
Mrs. Dungy?
Yes.
Dr. Greenberg?
Yes.
Mr. Mahalis?
Yes.
Mr. Rosenkranz?
Yes.
Mrs. Sohar?
Yes.
Mrs. Walker?
Yes.
President Cahill?
Yes.
7 yes.
Okay, that concludes the bill list for tonight.
Thank you, Mr. Rosenkranz. There are no second reading ordinances, so I'll move on to preliminary public comments to the council, subject to the following conditions and restrictions. During the preliminary public portion of the meeting, any person may address the Township Council on one subject for a maximum period of 5 minutes. Any such person desiring to speak during the preliminary public portion shall first sign a list maintained by the Township Clerk for such purpose. Comments during the preliminary public comment portion of the meeting shall not encompass second reading ordinances or any other matter for which comment or a public hearing is to occur at this meeting.
Junior Ramiro?
Yeah, he just switched around. Yeah, thanks. Or you can sit if you'd like, whatever, a couple.
Members of the council, vice president, president, and mayor. My name is Junior Romero. I'm with Food and Water Watch. We're an international environmental nonprofit with local office in New Brunswick, not too far from here. I've attempted to email members of the council and the mayor and the mayor's office regarding the Williams Transco Company pipeline expansion. Their fracked gas pipeline will be coming through Oldbridge, and Sayreville will be the township's most affected in Middlesex County. The route starts in Pennsylvania, where most of this gas is hydraulically fractured or fracked, and there will be a compressor station built in Franklin Township in Somerset County, which will compress the gas and accelerate it through the new pipes and old pipes, 50-year-old pipes, that are already in place here in Middlesex and Somerset County. The implications of accelerating and pressurizing gas through 50-year-old pipes that are already in our communities, I'm sure you can only imagine what can happen. They can explode. There can be gas leaks. The other portion besides Somerset and Middlesex County of this pipeline is through the Raritan Bay. Well, there will be a few more miles of gas pipeline added there. Of course, you can imagine if there's explosion or a leak with this gas, it can damage marine life along the Raritan Bay and commercial economies that thrive off of that. So I'm here to address the council and the mayor on this environmental issue, on this safety issue, and in the local level, the township can pass a resolution opposing the Williams pipeline. Right now, the company has filed with FERC, the Federal Energy and Regulatory Commission, which has to approve all pipelines, gas pipelines throughout the country. And there is a 3-week passage from now until 3 weeks from now where any organization, any person, any government can file as an intervener opposing or even supporting this gas pipeline project. And I would urge the members of the council and the mayor to hopefully pass a resolution opposing this project in Old Bridge and join townships like Franklin, like South Brunswick, like Montgomery Township in Somerset County, and be the first in Middlesex County to oppose this project. And I will gladly stay after the council meeting if any members of the council or the mayor have any more questions on this project. And I have business cards and will gladly stick around. So thank you for hearing me and appreciate it.
Thank you. Is that it for the
year? That's it.
Okay. Mm-hmm. I'll close the preliminary public portion of the meeting. Council member comments. Anybody have any comments tonight?
I just have a question. As far as the first aid committee that we had discussed at the budget hearing and last week, have we come up with an idea of if we're going to have the committee meeting soon and who would be on it?
The mayor, Mr. Shaw.
We have not put a committee together yet. I believe we'll ask the council when they want to meet and discuss the emergency as far as the first aid is concerned.
Okay.
It's not immediate, something that we need to do tomorrow, but just let me know when you just want to get together and talk. I think everybody knows the facts. Everybody's, we've discussed it at the budget meeting. We've discussed it at the meetings we've had with the first aid. I think all the council are well-versed on what's happening. So we just need to sit down and make some decisions.
Yeah,
and
I mean,
always available.
Yeah, I had spoken to Mr. Marion, I guess about 2 weeks ago about forming the committee.
About a week ago.
And he had, we had both discussed that the coordinator for Old Bridge Temps would be at the meeting. So I would like, because I want everyone to hear all sides. So I think it's important, in my opinion, to do it sooner than later.
Just let us know when you want to meet.
Well, what's the committee, who's it going to consist of? I mean, is it going to be the whole council? Do you want to just have a committee?
Or whoever.
Just, yes.
Well, I think it's incumbent on the council to constitute the committee, right? I mean, so the council's got to figure out what the council wants.
Mm-hmm.
So what does the council want?
Well, it's up to the council, but I think we should definitely have the coordinator there. The mayor will be there and some council members, I guess 3 council members, so we wouldn't have to have a...
A quorum?
Yes.
Right.
So, mm-hmm. I mean, I'm willing to be on it. I know a lot about it.
I have to see if the volunteer squads...
You can have 4 without it. You know.
Yes, I meant 4.
Right.
Everyone should be there. Who it's going to have an impact on.
All the volunteer squads.
All the volunteers.
Right.
All the volunteers, yes, exactly.
Would you like to take the lead on setting it up and getting people to participate? I mean...
Sure.
If I could, Mr. President,
yeah,
I would, just would suggest if you want to... again, establish a subcommittee of the whole committee that you can, I think that you may want to determine who those members are and take a vote on it, and then at least you'll know who those members are so that at least there's order. It's always good to know who the members of the committee would be or subcommittee would be, and I think that would be appropriate if that's what council wants to do. If you have members participate, I think the appropriate thing would be to establish a subcommittee.
Establish it and then vote on it.
Yeah, I mean, exactly.
So it would have to be in public then at the next meeting?
If that's what you...
I'm just trying to understand
right,
the process.
I mean, it would make sense to do that, come up with members who would like to be it, and then you can, however you share it, and we can establish it by resolution, subcommittee of the whole.
Okay, I can come up with... I'll find out from the first aid squads if they could send a representative from each one.
Right.
I could do that, and next meeting I could have the names.
And it would only be as far as, Ms. Walker, just as far as the council's concerned... The members, the members of council who would constitute the subcommittee.
That would have to be
Let's
voted
get that formalized.
So,
okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So you could take the lead on that, and if you do, we'll put it on the next agenda.
All right. Thank you. That's great. Thanks.
Yeah. About council comments. Council comments. Dr. Weinberg.
Yes, I just have a few. We talked about before, now that spring's coming and leading into Cheesequake Park, Gordon Road, we have a speeding area that a lot of people speed there, and there's always kids walking with their fishing poles there starting in the summer, and we were going to address that and also the sidewalk situation over there. I know there's patchwork where sidewalk was started with the development that went in, and it's almost like a sidewalk to nowhere. I didn't know whether, you know, we had any intention on putting more sidewalk over there, and if you could just put some traffic controls over there.
I'll make sure there's traffic control as far as speeding is concerned. But the sidewalk issue, I'm going back, had to be when I first became mayor, so it had to be over 5 years ago. There was an effort to put sidewalks on the, the west side of Gordon Road, and all the property owners on that side said no. They would not give the town the property to extend the sidewalks. And the other side of the street is owned by the state, and they won't allow sidewalks for the liability issues. So there was an effort to put sidewalks in there, and the people along Gordon Road that would have to give up the property, not one person was in favor of it. And that's going back quite a while. So we can try it again to see if they want to rethink it. Walking from the village now, when that new development is in place, we'll give an option now to not walk on Gordon Road, be able to walk through that development, gain access to sidewalks and into Schoolhouse Lane, where there are no sidewalks again. So there is a section where that new development is sidewalks to nowhere. Sidewalks to nowhere. It's a very dangerous road to walk down.
Yeah, there are sidewalks to nowhere, and maybe you want to readdress it with the neighbors again, because it is some of the neighbors who have called me to complain about the problem in the area. So maybe they're the ones who are willing to give up.
I got to go to the engineer. We sent out letters. There was letters sent out, and everybody sent it back. Not interested. Don't you dare.
Okay. Well, thanks
we'll
for trying, but if we could look into it.
That's the first I'm hearing about speeding on Gordon Road. I know that's a very sharp. It looks like you're speeding, but you might only be doing 10 miles an hour, and you're still on two wheels. It's a very sharp corner. But we'll have the radar out there.
And then the second issue with our parks and recreation, considering that the spring, there's going to be a lot of people using the field, soccer starting up, baseball starting up. I just want to make sure that the fields are up to speed, and not only that, the water and the bathrooms are available.
Yes, our fields are in good shape. This rain put them out of commission this following weekend. I'm a little concerned with all the rain, another 2 to 3 inches of rain before now and the weekend, and we certainly don't want to tear them up early in the season because then we can't get them back. So it's going to be weather-driven, how the fields stay, the uses of the fields, and that's the advantage of the all-weather fields at Begike. You can play on them 5 minutes after it stops raining. So maybe that's something we need to consider moving forward if we are going to be building new fields or converting some of our existing fields to all-weather turf. But when you have pipeline, with the natural gas, it's a challenge when you have this kind of weather. We had that big snowstorm with all that ice and water on the fields, then we've been followed up with weeks and weeks of rain. So we'll do the best we can, and they're in good shape. The fields are in good shape. We want to keep it that way.
Yes. Okay, and the third issue is on Higgins Road on the east side heading north. We've repaired there's the pothole there. If you go there tonight and you're heading towards 516, okay, there's a huge pothole there, and because it's on the bend where the road narrows, if there's two cars, you are sure to go in it if you're heading in that direction. We have fixed it multiple times, and I don't understand why it keeps on, you know, becoming under
probably a sub-base issue, and where it is on the radius, it's just taking a beating. But Kyle's here. He'll go over there. If we have to dig that out a little bit, maybe.
Yeah.
We'll get some base down first and try to do the best we can. But, yeah, at that... I've been around it.
People's tire, it's bad. So thank you for addressing that.
Take a look at that.
Any other comments, Council? Mrs. Sohar?
Last week, Mr. Weiner was here to ask us about the plowing. He was very upset. Were we able to take care of what was wrong and make sure that
there's a plow there waiting right now for it to snow.
No, but just make sure he's on that
grid.
Yeah,
there was Kyle could fill us in. Yeah. There was some confusion. But I think there was Mr. Werner's report. The road has been plowed. He was never 30-inch snowfall was, I think, over 3 years ago.
Well, I had spoken to him a while back, you know, and I had thought that everything was okay. You know, I had given him my number and I didn't hear from him, so I assumed that things were right. But evidently the other night he was upset. I just want to make sure as a constituent that he's been, you know, addressed and that his needs are being met.
He would call a day or two before it snowed and tell us that we would call down to Public Works and say, make sure you get that road. Kyle, go ahead.
Yes, I met with him after the meeting last week. I gave him my cell number. I asked him to give me a call next time during a snow event if there's any issues out there. And I said, we'll make sure that someone comes over and takes care of it right away. I also looked at our zoning maps for each of our snow zones. And he's on a little half moon that wasn't highlighted on our zone map. Right. So I'll make sure for the upcoming contract for the 2017-2018 snow season that is highlighted and that our contractors will cover that area.
Yeah, thank you. I appreciate that.
No, I'm sorry. I just forgot to ask one thing.
Sure.
The TNR committee, because I know we have only 60 days, and were we going to move forward with a committee so we can get it going?
The ordinance said it would be established 60 days after adoption. That's what that was the. That was
oh, I thought it said it had to be within 60. I thought it's
after adoption.
60 days after adoption.
After, I thought it said within. Okay.
That was the First Amendment. Everybody went,
yeah, but I thought it said within. Okay.
Any other comments? Comments? No? Okay. I'll close the council member comments. Report of the township clerk?
None at this time. Thank you.
Report of the township attorney?
Thank you, Mr. President. Today was the we had a hearing before Judge Natale. Judge Natale is the judge who took over for Judge Wolfson in connection with the affordable housing litigation. And today was the return of our compliance hearing, at which the court had to determine whether or not our proposed housing plan was in compliance with the requirements of UHAC rules and met the intent to provide reasonable opportunity for affordable housing. Please report that based upon what the testimony presented, that the court did make a determination granting us preliminary final compliance and preliminary repose, which means that our plan was preliminary approved and repose, meaning that developers can't file a builder's remedy suit against us. And the reason why it was preliminary, because there were a few items that the special master had called out that needed to be addressed. None of them substantive, or else he could have continued the hearing. It included making a few minor changes to the spending plan, which is spending plan is something that Mr. Remsa, the planner, had prepared. Making some minor changes to the development fee ordinance, adding language indicating that it was approved by the court, because currently our development fee ordinance says it was approved by COA. Amending, there was an issue with respect to adoption of, that's on our agenda tonight, is the amendments to the ordinances that were previously adopted. I'm calling it an omnibus ordinance. Again, those changes were recommended by the special master. And again, it's nothing substantive, but those are things that she had requested be included to each of the individual ordinances that were previously adopted. Now, obviously, I know how votes have gone in the past, and we had it up last time. There was changes to be made, and I know we're short a couple votes, but I mean, at the end of the day, this is an ordinance that the court has conditioned our final approval on being adopted, which means that ultimately, to the extent that the court, the town doesn't adopt it, that a party can file a motion in front of the judge, and then the judge can deem it adopted. But in that instance, they can also seek attorney's fees and costs. While what I'm asking council tonight, and I know there are members of the council who have been in opposition to affordable housing, and I understand that, but to the extent that we brought it up here, I would ask that at least for purposes of this evening, we can move it for introduction, and then we can move forward for final adoption, hopefully with the full council. Because again, I think there's a, and I know there's been a lot of discussion, but there's a constitutional obligation for the town to provide affordable housing. We put together, I believe, which is a very good plan. The judge had commented on it as well, indicating the town recognizes its responsibility and then trying to meet the requirements of its residents as well. So he understands the process. But again, it's a condition of our final approval. The danger is that if we ultimately don't get final approval, then we're susceptible to challenges. But I think at the end of the day, if this ordinance isn't finally adopted, then it allows either the interveners or Fair Share Housing to go before the court, indicate that the town is possibly not acting in good faith, and then at that point, then again we lose control. So I would ask again, and I'm going to, while we moved it for this reading to give you opportunity, that I just want to go forward with at least introducing it. And to the extent that we can then schedule for hearing on the 17th, because that's what I represented to the judge. That's what I'm asking the council to do this evening. Then finally, there will be a final hearing 90 days from today, assuming we meet all the conditions that the special master outlined. That's when we would get our final order of compliance and an order of repose, which would protect the town for, actually now we're down to 8 years, but it would be that 10-year gap from 2015 to 2025.
Thank you. Is there an administrative report tonight? Wow, look at that. Okay. All right, move on to the consent agenda. Tonight we have items C1 through C5. I'll ask for a motion to introduce items C1 through C5, please.
I'll move it.
Move by Mr. Rosenkrantz.
Second.
Second by Mrs.
Dungy.
Thank you. Anybody from the council want to be, from the public want to be heard on items C1 through C5? I'll close the public portion. Are there any separations from council? Mrs. Walker.
C5.
Any other separations from council? Dr. Greenberg?
C3.
C3. Any other separations? I have a motion on the balance, please, which is 1, 2, and 4.
I'll make a motion, sir.
Moved by Mr. Miles. Can I have a second, please?
Second.
I'll second it. Roll call, please, on the balance, which is 1, 2, and 4.
Mrs. Dungy?
Yes.
Dr. Greenberg?
Yes.
Mr. Mollis?
Yes.
Mr. Rosenkrantz?
Yes.
Mrs. Sohar?
Yes.
Mrs. Walker?
Yes.
President Cale?
Yes.
7 yes on the balance.
Okay. Dr. Greenberg, C3?
For abstention.
For abstention. Anybody have any comments on C3? Can I get a motion on C3, please?
I'll move it.
Moved by Mr. Rosenkrantz. Can I have a second?
Second.
Second by Mrs. Sohar? Thank you. Roll call on C3.
Mrs. Dungy?
Yes.
Dr. Greenberg?
Yes.
Oh, so
C3
is abstention.
Mr. Mollis?
Yes.
Mr. Rosenkrantz?
Yes.
Mrs. Sohar?
Yes.
Mrs. Walker?
Yes.
President Cale?
Yes.
6 yes, 1 abstention.
C5, Mrs. Walker?
Yes. Just so the people at home know, for the COA Council, it's an increase. I just want to say that this COA, as you all know, I'm opposed to COA. I just really wish that our representatives from the state level down would have helped fight COA, if we could have formed some kind of coalition, because this is so costly to all the towns. And not only that, it's going to affect our infrastructure, our schools, and it's going to be such a financial burden on not only Oldbridge, but many, many towns in the state. And I just oppose COA.
The comments on C5.
If I could, Mr. President.
Mrs. Dungy has a question.
Yep.
Mrs. Dungy?
Yes. I was kind of looking back over my notes. Is this the same? Appears to be the same one that we approved the increase back in July. Am I correct?
Back in when?
Back in July.
Why? I don't know. I'm not sure. I don't know off the top of my head.
No.
Okay.
I guess my question to follow up on that is why. If it is right, according to what I looked at, July 11th, why are they coming back again for more increase?
Yeah, I think the attorney can explain that.
Okay.
Yep.
So again, with respect to C5, the actual original contract was $55,000. What had happened, obviously, is that there was, because of the amount of work that was done last year, this relates to the contract from last year, 2016. These were the funds, additional funds needed to close out that purchase order. The one thing I would say is that the overall cost was mitigated, or helped to mitigate, because I did a lot of the work as well, for which the township wasn't billed. And again, this is charged to the trust fund. And while I know that there's council members who are opposed to it, this involves a contract for which the work was done. And I can tell you that the extent and the amount of work at the rate that they're being charged, while it's significant, and I don't disagree with that, and there are costs associated with it, I think it's still fair and reasonable. And I think at the end of the day, you do have a contract with the township. And I review their bills, and I ensure that the bills are appropriate. And when necessary, I have reduced certain charges that I felt that weren't appropriate. So again, it's for additional work from relating back to the 2016 contract.
This is work that's been performed.
Correct. It has been performed. But because the contract amount was set at $55,000, right, we need to amend the contract for the additional $2,056.40.
Understood. Any other questions, Mrs. Dungy? Or is that?
Well, I guess I would go with this because it's a small amount, but I guess I was just curious as to if this is going to be a continuous coming back for more money.
Well, the only thing I can say, Ms. Dungy, is that, you tried to, the local public contracts law requires municipalities to establish a contract amount. And so you do it the best that you can to estimate the amount. And so, yeah, it's sort of a guess. You look at the amount of work that's going to be done, you put an amount in there, and you don't always get it right. So what you trially tend to do is, keep it lower as opposed to establishing it higher. So now that's a way for you to continue to monitor the bills and monitor the amount being billed. So fortunately, we're almost through the process, and we're on to 2017. So as far as 2016 is concerned, this is the last for 2016. But that's why sometimes you have to amend, like, for instance, the same thing with the other contract on here.
Mm-hmm.
You try to estimate what's the amount of the work, because you have to, by law, put a contract amount in there. You don't always get it right. So then that requires you to come back on and then do the amendment to the contract.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay. Any other questions on C5? Got a motion on C5, please?
Make a motion.
Mr. Mollis moved it. Can I get a second?
Second.
Second by Mr. Rosenkranz. Roll call on C5, please.
Mrs. Dungy?
Yes.
Dr. Greenberg?
Abstain.
Mr. Mollis?
Yes.
Mr. Rosenkranz?
Yes.
Mrs. Sohar?
Yes.
Mrs. Walker?
Yes, they did the work, but I think the state should give us some money back.
President Cahill?
Yes.
6 yes, 1 abstention.
Moving on to ordinances for first reading, as the attorney spoke about, FR1.
Or was approved?
C4 was in the body. As the attorney spoke about during the meeting, I'll just read the ordinance into the record.
The title.
Yeah. Ordinance of the Township of Walbridge amending sections of Ordinance 2016-20, 2016-21, 2016-22, 2016-23, and 2016-24. Which previously amended Chapter 250 of the Code of the Township of Walbridge, entitled Walbridge Township Land Development Ordinance. Can I get a motion, please?
I'll move it.
Moved by Mr. Rosenkranz. I have a second, please. Sir. Second by Mr. Miles. Roll call on FR1.
Mrs. Dungy?
No.
Dr. Greenberg?
No.
Mr. Miles?
Yes.
Mr. Rosenkranz?
Yes.
Mrs. Sohar?
No.
Mrs. Walker?
No.
President Cahill?
Yes.
3 yes, 4 no.
Okay. Failed. We have to go back to the judge, I guess. All right. Okay, moving on to public comments on any subject matter. Anybody want to be heard? Yes, sir. Good evening. Just name an address for the record.
My name is Neil Greenspan, 7 Carassa Street. Last week you had the vote on the budget. To give you my qualifications, I've done $1 million budgets for 30 years, every year by December. I have no problem. What my problem is the abstention of the budget. You either like it or you don't like it. There is no, the members had the budget in their hands on February 3rd. It was voted on March 27th. That's 2 months to go over the budget. While I was asking questions about this, my name was being discredited by certain members of the Democratic Club, and I'm calling them out, and it's too bad if they don't like it. George Millett put a post up there and said, the reason why June didn't know much about the budget is because the town didn't give them enough notification of the budget, of the meetings and the budget itself. So I looked into it myself. And I found out that all the council members have received the budget on February 3rd. They had 3 meetings, March 1st, March 9th, and March 16th, if I'm correct, to go over the budget. If there was any questions that needed to be asked, that was the point to ask it. You don't go to the budget meeting that it's going to be voted on and say, I don't understand the budget. I don't know what's going to be in Ward 3. No one asks questions. I live in Ward 3. I still don't know what's going to happen in Ward 3. I'll go to the town and I'll ask the questions myself. And I know that on both parties, they go over before the meetings, they go over the agenda. So since the people of the Democratic Party, without me mentioning their names in the post, criticized me and defaced, try to deface me, I really don't care, I'm not running for anything. And I'm calling out right now, Mark Rezzoli, Dave Merwin, Bill Saris, the George Millett, who wrote the post, I don't know who the guy was that was criticizing me. Why didn't you help June through this process? And June, why didn't you ask the questions that needed to be asked during these meetings? And that's all I have to say. I'm just totally upset about this whole thing.
Okay, thank you. Anybody else want to be heard from the public? I'll close the public portion. We are going to go into executive session, and we will return to vote on an item. You want to read it? Or?
Sure.
Yep. Thank you.
Need a motion to adopt a resolution to go into executive session for purposes of discussing litigation matter known as Bleich, B-L-E-I-C-H, versus Township of Old Bridge et al. And we are recessing and will reconvene in public.
I need a motion to go into executive session, please. Move Dr. Greenberg. Have a second?
Second.
By Mrs. Sohar. Thank you. Roll call to go into executive session.
Mrs. Dungy.
Yes.
Dr. Greenberg.
Yes.
Mr. Mollis.
Yes.
Mr. Rosenkranz.
Yes.
Mrs. Sohar.
Yes.
Mrs. Walker.
Yes.
President Cahill.
Yes.
7 yes.
Okay, I'll take a motion to come out of executive session and to reconvene in public.
I'll move it.
Moved by Dr. Weinberg, second by Mrs. Sohar. Roll call, please.
Mrs. Dungy?
Yes.
Dr. Greenberg?
Yes.
Mr. Mollis?
Yes.
Mr. Rosenkranz?
Yes.
Mrs. Sohar?
Yes.
Mrs. Walker?
Yes.
President Cahill?
Yes.
7 yes.
We'll just come out of executive session to discuss litigation. Mr. Attorney?
Sure. Mr. President, thank you. You have before you is a resolution approving a settlement of litigation matter known as Janine Blake and Paul Blake versus Matchaponics Estates, Inc. et al., including the Township of Old Bridge, in which the town was represented by its insurance fund attorney, Mr. Morey, who negotiated and recommended a settlement of the plaintiff's claims against the township for the sum of $50,000. And so what's before you is a resolution to approve that settlement.
Thank you. Any questions on the settlement that we discussed? I got a roll call. Can I get a motion to move? Motion to move it, please. I'll move it. I got a second, please.
Second
by Mrs. Dungy. Thank you. Roll call on the resolution.
Mrs. Dungy?
Yes.
Dr. Greenberg?
Yes.
Mr. Malas?
Yes.
Mr. Rosenkranz?
Yes.
Mrs. Sohar?
Yes.
Mrs. Walker?
Yes.
President Kayle?
Yes.
Seven yes.
Councilmember comments before we adjourn? Anybody want to add anything? Dr. Greenberg?
I just want to say, while voting for the ordinance for first reading tonight, I just want to let you know that I do respect the law, but I had concerns when the zoning was changed for the Alfieri property, and I didn't feel all the COA requirements had to be met with apartments. So I thought I should explain my reasoning for voting that way. And I just wanted to get that on record. And it's unfortunate the COA situation has not been resolved from the state down. And we saw tonight that there is a cost to the taxpayer. And the whole process is not really research properly when we're expanding the amount of units in town so much and not taking in consideration the roads, the infrastructure, the cost to the, you know, that it will take to our police, fire, first aid. And so there's many, many reasons involved with it. Obviously, this is what we're faced with coming down from a court order, which I don't agree. A judge has the right to do that. So I just wanted to say why I voted no. Thank you.
Any other council comments? Mrs. Walker.
Yes, I wanted to comment also why I voted no. I feel the same way. The thing that upset me the most about changing the zoning was the Alfieri property, because it was supposed to be a hotel conference center with just single-family homes, and that should not have been changed. I was very much against that. And I just think that COA is very detrimental to all of the communities in the whole state, and something has to be done to stop it. Because it's going to, our infrastructure, the police, the fire, the ambulance, this is all going to be affected. Because now we have another over 3,000 apartments coming to Old Bridge.
Anybody else want to make any comments?
Sure.
Mrs. Sohar?
Yes, I also would like to speak to this subject. I know we've been told on occasion that perhaps this was the way to go, that if we didn't go this way, we would have more and it would be more problematic. But we didn't, I don't think we gave it a fair chance to do just that. I think we could have tried to fight it. That's my opinion, and I'm entitled to that opinion. I really do not like the idea of that many apartments coming to town. I think that it's going to be really a very difficult situation on the school system. And I just think that we could maybe have done something a little bit different in terms of how we were going to do the usage. As far as Alfieri is concerned, that to me was a disgrace. We should have never allowed him that kind of a project to move forward.
Anybody else? Council comments?
Sure.
Mr. Rosenkranz.
So since we're all giving our opinion, I'll give my opinion as well. And while I respect everybody's opinion, I didn't think we had much of a choice. We didn't have any room to negotiate any additional reductions in the amount of housing and apartments and units that the court and Fair Share Housing said that Old Bridge had to provide. So we were given a number, and we worked down from that number. We worked down from 10,000 to less than 3,000 or around 3,000. So if we had gone to court, we would have had incurred some legal expense and no guarantee that the 3,000 negotiated settlement would not have been further up in number, given the court's previous decisions against another township where they did not settle and they got more than if they would have settled. So this was the best of a bad situation, in my opinion, that we settled.
Anybody else hasn't spoken yet? Okay. Yeah, I guess I'll chime in on call because I voted for it. You know, I think that there's been a lot of discussion about how many apartments, how many dwelling units, et cetera, et cetera. I think the public needs to understand that this is, all we did was change the zoning. Nothing has been approved. This was just to change zoning. So these developments might not even happen. All we did was change the zoning. You know, we could have fought it. We could have absolutely fought it. You know, we're one of 536 municipalities, or whatever the number, 563 municipalities that are all under this edict by the Supreme Court of the state of New Jersey. My gut is, based on talking with the attorney and other discussions we've had, is that we more than likely would have lost, and it would have cost us probably more units zoned than we have today, and the legal fees would have been pretty exorbitant. That's my opinion, and you know we can you know debate this till the cows come home, but that's my opinion. So you know I just want to get that on the record. This is zoning changes. There's no approvals for apartments or building, etc. These are just zoning changes. With that, I'll close the council member comments.
Council
take
President,
a motion.
Can I make a comment?
Absolutely,
no, not
Mr.
on the council.
Mayor.
I'll end the comments on, I think, a good note, no pun intended. We put our $20 million bonds out the other day for bid, and we received a rate of 2.12% for those bonds, which is actually below the rate that a AAA town was given. I believe today a town was given 2.19, so we actually got a better rate than a town rated AAA.
Terrific.
So we're very excited about that.
Congratulations to you and Montu and the whole administration. That's terrific. Excellent.
Thank you. The council should be proud also.
Thank you. Motion to adjourn. Moved by Dr. Weinberg. Second, please.
Second,
Mrs. Soha. Roll call, please.
Mrs. Dundry?
Yes.
Dr. Greenberg?
Yes.
Mr. Malas?
Yes.
Mr. Rosenkranz?
Yes.
Mrs. Soha?
Yes.
Mrs. Walker?
Yes.
President Cahill?
Yes.
Seven yes.
We are adjourned.